अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ रीबा अंसर एंड आई एम फ्रॉम यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ लाहौर इस्लामाबाद कैंपस। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट रेटिनोब्लास्टोमा। सो बेसिकली फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज रेटिनोब्लास्टोमा? इट इज़ अ मेलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर दैट अफेक्ट्स रेटिनल न्यूरोसेंसरी लेयर। रेटिना कंटेन्स लाइट सेंसिटिव सेल्स दैट सेंड इलेक्ट्रिकल नर्व इम्पल्सेस फ्रॉम ऑप्टिक नर्व टू ब्रेन। इट कॉमनली इफेक्ट्स चिल्ड्रन एंड It can be heritable and non-heritable. If we talk about heritable retinoblastoma, it is autosomal dominant and occurs due to mutation in RB1 gene that is present on chromosome number 13. RB1 is tumor suppressing gene. Now, what causes retinoblastoma is that abnormal mutation occurs in retinal nerve cells. This causes rapid growth of cells. This rapid growth started covering normal cells and creates a mass of cells forming a tumor. Now let's have a look at clinical features of retinoblastoma. It comes in two stages, Kuntzian stage and red eye stage. Kuntzian stage is also called as silent stage because it is less painful. Leukocoria, squint, nystagmus, defective vision, they all come in Kuntzian stage. Leukocoria gives white reflex, that is why it is also called emeritic cat's eye. Here you can see white reflex, deviated eye with white reflex. It can be unilateral or bilateral. Now the second stage, that is red eye stage. This stage is painful. Redness and watering of eyes occurs in this stage. Also, chances of acute secondary glaucoma are high in this stage. That is why it is also called as glaucomatous stage. Glaucoma can occur because as the tumor grows, it pushes the iris lens diaphragm, hence blocking the angle. Or tumor cells migrate and block trabecular meshwork, due to which less drainage occurs. Intraocular pressure raises, due to which proptosis can occur, that is protrusion of the eyeball. Orbital inflammation can occur. Intraocular inflammation can occur that leads to acute uveitis in which pseudohypopyon can appear. Progressive enlargement of globe leads to bursting at sclera, weakest part of the sclera, that is limbus sclerocorneal junction. Now these cells extend towards extraocular tissues and rapid fungation starts, as shown in this image. Now let's talk about pathology. Gross pathology gives chalky white calcified masses, and microscopically it gives rosities and fluidities. There are three kinds of rosities: flexural vitreous rosity that is specific for retinoblastoma and have a single layer of columnar cells arranged around a clear lumen. Second, we have homoid rosities. They are not specific for retinoblastoma and have central neural fibers. Third, pseudo rosities. They have necrotic area around blood vessels. Fluidities are highly specific for retinoblastoma and they are flower bouquet type aggregation of tumor cells. Diagnosis: we can diagnose retinoblastoma through proper examination, ultrasounds, OCT scans and MRI. Treatment depends upon tumor size, location and stage of growth. Generally speaking, we can do tumor destructive therapy, in which we can perform chemotherapy, transpupillary thermotherapy, photocoagulation, cryotherapy, brachytherapy, and etc. We can also go for enucleation if tumor involves more than half of the retina or optic nerve is involved.